Hey and welcome back to another Darkfall video. So today I want to review the website textures.com, which used to be known as cgtextures.com. So it's a great place to get all your assets from, no matter what your kind of assets you're looking for, pretty much guaranteed that it's here. This website, the way it works, once you've logged in and created a free account, you get 3 credits a day. So 15 credits each day you get to spend on any kind of assets that you're looking for. So recently they've done something called the Great Overhaul, which they put a lot of time and effort into scanning materials and creating high quality assets or Pbr materials for you to use. So I just want to show you this website and how it works and just show you how great it is to start building your asset library. So what we can do, you can search for something specific, or instead what I'm going to do is go to Pbr Materials. So there's a whole bunch of materials here, and this is generally what it will look like once you've loaded it into Blender. So you can go ahead and look through all these materials here and find something that you like. So let's say we found one that we like. If we scroll down, there's the different images that we need. So we first need the image, which would be the texture. Then the height, if we wanted to use it for a displace modifier, you could load that one too. But generally what you need is to download the color map, the normal, and the roughness. Download the ambient occlusion if you want to as well. So with these images, we can load them into Blender and make our scene look a lot better. So select the size that you want to download and just click download. Your credits will be deducted. So once it's saved, you can go ahead and open it up and save it to your asset library. So I'm going to download this one. I'm also going to download this one for the height. You don't necessarily need it, since you've got the normal map, but if you want to download this one too, you can go ahead and do that. So download it. So as you notice, these cost the same credits, even though it's a smaller size. If you wanted the larger sizes, you would have to become a premium member and it would cost more credits, but 1024 by 1024 is a decent size anyway. So, you know, generally you should be okay with that size. So go ahead and download these and then save these into a folder and name it for your asset library. Then once you've downloaded your assets, you can go ahead and load up a scene. Let's get rid of the diffuse. Shift A, go to shader, principal shader, or you can use a Pbr shader that you've already created. Shift A, go to texture, image texture. I drop this here, and this is going to be for the color, so let's go straight into the base color. Let's open up our image. So this is my textures asset library, I guess, and it's full of all different images and different things. But for the Pbr, I save that into a different folder. And then I can go ahead and choose, let's have a look, brick wall. So I have all the different images. I'm going to choose the color for this. And then since it needs a bit more work, so let's duplicate this, Shift D. Let's change the image. This one's going to be for the roughness. So select the roughness map. Plug this into the roughness here. So it's still not working how we expect it to, and what you need to do is go to the color here and change this to non-color data. Since we want to use the color for this, that's fine. Everything else we need to make sure it's non-color data. So Shift D, duplicate this again. And this is going to be for the normal map, so we do need to use another node. But let's first load in our normal map. Shift A, go to vector, go to bump. Drop this here. Let's plug this color into the height and then this normal into the normal. So now it's going to use all those normals, and we want to reduce the strength and again play around with this to something that will fit your scene. But that looks fine. Again, same thing with the distance as well. Shift D, duplicate this node, and this is going to be for the cavity, so to make it even deeper between these lines here. And you don't have to do this step, this is for extra detail if you need to. Open up cavity and plug this into the displacement. And if you want to reduce it as well, which has far too has far too deep, so you can also add in a converter color ramp. Play around with this until it's a lot smoother. So this is a great way to build your assets for free. So there's a whole bunch of materials that you can use. Just download a couple of files each day, and this is a great website, and it always has been a great website. It's just recently been overhauled and it's just even better, so I'm pleased we're using this website since it's a free service. So if you've not used this before, I'll throw a link in the description, you can go and check it out. But if you think there's some other websites that are worth a mention, then go ahead and leave a comment below. But hopefully this video helped. As always, thank you for watching, and until next time, see you around.